فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. وإن شرح هذا الكتاب التحفة السرية في شرح مقدمة الآجرومية written by ابن آجروم رحمه الله تعالى. And the sharh is written by Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. So the muqaddimah is written by Ibn Ajurrum, and the sharh is written by Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, rahimahullahu ta'ala. We were in last lesson, Niyabatu al-Fath 'an al-Kasra. We spoke about that the fatha fatakunu 'alamatan lil-khafdi fi al-ism alladhi la yansarif. We stopped at this point. And we said the fatha is shown in place of what? The kasra. Okay? When the ism is what? Ismu alladhi la yansarif. When the ism is ismu alladhi la yansarif. And we said next lesson we're going to leave that point from, because it requires great explanation. And it needs from us to go in great details regarding what is meant by al-ism alladhi la yansarif. So let's go to the sharh written by Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, and let's see what he says. He says, وَأَمَّا الْفَتْحَةُ فَتَكُونُ عَلَامَةً لِلْخَفْضِ فِي الْإِسْمِ الَّذِي لَا يَنْصَرِفُ وَأَقُولُ لِلْفَتْحَةِ مَوْضِعٌ وَاحِدٌ تَكُونُ فِيهِ عَلَامَةً عَلَى الْخَفْضِ الْإِسْمِ وَهُوَ الْإِسْمُ الَّذِي لَا يَنْصَرِفُ وَمَعْنَى كَوْنِهِ لَا يَنْصَرِفُ أَنَّهُ لَا يَقْبَلُ الصَّرْفَ وَهُوَ التَّنْوِينُ. So he says to you, the fatha takes the place of the kasra only in one place. There's only one time that you're going to see in which the word becomes what? Fatha instead of a kasra. And that is, he said, it is وَهُوَ الْإِسْمُ الَّذِي لَا يَنْصَرِفْ. And then he defines for you what it means, ismu alladhi la yansarif. He says, wa ma'na kawnihi la yansarif. The meaning that is meant by la yansarif, it means annahu la yaqbalu sarfa, that it doesn't accept sarf. Wa huwa tanwinu. And the sarf is what? The sarf is what? It's tanwin. The sarf is, it is tanwin. وَالْإِسْمُ الَّذِي لَا يَنْصَرِفُ هُوَ. And the ism that does not accept tanween is. So now, brothers, you have to understand the definition of what is meant by the ism that does not accept tanween. Are we all together? وَالْإِسْمُ الَّذِي لَا يَنْصَرِفُ. The ism that does not accept sarf. It is الَّذِي أَشْبَهَ الْفِعْلَ. It is the one that, this is the dhabit that the Shaykh Rahimahullah has placed for it. And the grammarians have put for it. It is al-ismu alladhi la yansarifu huwa. The ism that doesn't accept tanween is alladhi ashbaha al-fi'la. It is the one that has, it looks like a verb. Fi wujudi illatayni far'iyatayni. Because it has two what? It has two illa. Two defects. There's two defects that are both fara, sub branches. Hey, Saad, what does it mean? It has two illa and they are sub branches. What does that mean? What does he mean? It's the verb, so it's the noun that looks like the verb. So when you say, when he say illatayni here, and you say far'iyatayni, he's not talking about the noun. What's he talking about? He's talking about the verb. He said, alladhi ashbaha al-fi'la. It looks like the verb. في وجودي in it, the verb is علتين فرعيتين. The ism is looking like the verb because of two illa, two defects that are both sub-branches. They're not asal, they're both sub-branches. And I'll explain what it means, both of that. But I want Sa'ad to try. What is علتين? What does it mean? Okay, good. So the two illa that the fi'il has, that the ism has become like it, is what? Number one is what? And the second one is? It's ma'na. What does it mean, lafz? What does the sheikh mean when he say lafz? The illa is illa lafziya in the verb. What does it mean? Yeah? No verb accepts him in Aslan. There's no such thing as verb accepts him. We found a ism here. Are we all together? And this ism said it doesn't accept tanween. So the question is, why does it happen that a noun does not accept tanween? We said it looks like a verb. Okay? Good. What is it that it looks like the verb with? We said that the verb, so we have to first tell them what the verb is, and then we can tell what the noun looks like the verb in, right? So let's first of all talk about what the verb is. The verb, we said, has two illa in it. Those two illa are far'iyataini. They are two illa which are, they're two defects. Illa means defect. Okay? And both of those illa are what? Furu', a far'a, sub-branch. Stems from an asal. Good. So I'm asking you, what is meant by the first of the two? You said to me, it's tarji'u ila lafzi, it goes back to the wording. I asked what it's meant by it goes back to the wording. You then said to me, it's pronunciation. I said, no. Yeah? What do you mean the way it's written? So the verb then resembles something. It's an ongoing, no. What is it, Imran?
Construction of the verb.
Huh?
Construction of the verb.
No. No.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah?
Good.
I mentioned this before. The first illa that is in the verb is what? The first illa goes back to the wording. What do we mean when we say it goes back to the wording? The word daraba. Is it not a fi'il? It daraba fi'il. Daraba, where has he been taken from? It's been taken from a masdar, a verb or noun. Hey, what's the masdar that it's taken from? Yeah? It is taken from darb, right? Daraba is taken from min al-darbi. It's taken from darb, right? Good. So what? Here we have daraba, and it's taken from something. And then the first illa that's in it is what? That the fi'il that you see is mushtaq, is rooted from something. Are you with me? Are we all together on that? So what is it? So the first one we said it's illa. That's the illa. Hey, what does it mean far'iyya when he says far'iyya? Hey, Imran. Yeah? Hey? Does anyone know? He said it's illa. He said illataini, two illas. And then he said far'iyataini, both of them are far'a. What does he mean by both of them are far'a?
Branch.
Yeah?
Branch.
Yeah, branch from where? You just answered it if you think about what you said. If the word is rooted from something, then it's not the farah, right? So it's not the asr, sorry, it's the farah. If taraba is taken from a darb, which is the asal, then it's a farah, it's a sub-branch. Sah? Then the mushtaq is taken from the what? The mushtaq minhu. Taken from the mushtaq minhu. Sahih? Which is a mazdar here, right? Am I making sense? قعد قعود قرأ قراءة أكل الأكل. All of those are what? Any verb you bring, that's always taken from verb or noun. قعد is taken from what? It's taken from قعود. صح? All of those words, هلول مجرة. Any verb that you see is مشتق, it's taken from something. Good. فرعيتين means what? Because it's a فرع. The verb is a فرع. The أصل is what? The مصدر is the أصل. صح? Is the أصل is the مصدر. Good. The second one is what? The second one is here. The second meaning, he says to you now, الذي أشبه الفعل في وجود علتين فرعيتين إحداهما ترجع إلى اللفظ. One goes back to the لفظ. والأخرى. And the second one is ترجع إلى المعنى. It goes back to the meaning. هي سعد, what's meant by the meaning? Yeah? That's the ism. You're going to the ism. We're going to go to the ism. We're talking about the fi'il first. Remember, we have to explain what the fi'il is. And then we're going to talk about what the ism resembles it in. We're talking about the is-fi'il now. Because he said to you, the ism الذي لا ينصرف is what? What's the ism الذي لا ينصرف? The ism that doesn't accept and win is the ism that looks like a verb in two things. So we're talking about the verb here. The first one is that there's a it looks like the verb in two illa that are in the verb. The first illa that's in the verb is what? إحداهما ترجع إلى اللفظ. One goes back to the wording. والأخرى, and the second one is ترجع إلى المعنى. It goes back to the meaning. So what's meant by the meaning? Yeah. Hey, Imran. You said, Estelle, I got this. Don't worry, man. I know this properly. So you sure? You said, yes, I am. Yeah? Huh? I asked you, صح, if you knew it. What did he say? Now, what did he say? And I said, are you sure? What did he say? So the second one is what? ترجعو. It goes back to the meaning. What do we mean by it goes back to the meaning? Yeah? The reason I'm asking you guys, because I mentioned this to you guys in the Mutammima. I explained this to you guys in the Mutammima. احتياجه إلى الفاعل. The fi'il always needs a fa'il. This word, the meaning always requires something that did it. Are we all together? احتياجه. The second is that it requires and it needs, it's hungry. احتياجه إلى الفاعل, it requires a fa'il. And this is the illa which is ma'nawiyya, right? This is illa ma'nawiyya now. That you can never see a verb that's without her. Because we're not atheists, are we? Are we atheists? No, we're not. We believe every action, it has a doer, right? Every action, what does it require? A fa'il. Are we all together? Does that make sense? Then when the Sheikh says, الَّذِي أَشْبَهَ الْفِعْلَ فِي وُجُودِ عِلَّتَيْنِ فَرْعِيَتَيْنِ إِحْدَاهُمَا, one of them, تَرْجِعُ إِلَى اللَّفْضِ, it goes back to the wording. We know what it means, إِلَّا اللَّفْضِيَ, right? If I ask you what's إِلَّا اللَّفْضِيَ, what do you say? اشْتِقَاقُهُ مِنَ الْمَصْدَرِ. It's rooting. اشْتِقَاقُهُ مِنَ الْمَصْدَرِ. It's rooting from a مَصْدَرِ. والأخرى ترجع إلى المعنى. And the second one, it goes back to the معنى. You say احتياجه إلى الفاعل. It's needing of a فاعل. صح? So here we have علتين فرعيتين. The first one is علة, which is علة لفظية. And the second one is علة 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 معنوية. Are we all together? علة علة معنوية. Very good. Both of the two, are they farah? Okay, we understand that mushtaq is a what? Yeah? The mushtaq is taken from what? The mushtaq minhu. Hey, what about how is the ma'nawi farah? Saad? How is the ma'nawi farah? Yeah? Hey, what's the asal? That's the first one. That's the wording now. No, let's say the illah that goes back to that illah is the wording. We agree on that. It's always going to carry on in every example. But it's going to, there's an illah also in the meaning that's independent from the wording. And we have this, the Sheikh said it's fara'iyya. It's a fara'. So, how is a fara' in the meaning? Abbas, you want to try? Yeah? You're thinking. Think out loud. Are you? Huh? Okay, would you break that down? Yeah. The muhtaj is always a fara' of what? The muhtaj minhu. Sah? Just like the mushtaq is a fara' of the mushtaq minhu. It's a branch that doesn't have anything without this one. So it's a fara' from it. It's a branch that stems from it. The muhtaj ilayhi, sorry. Very good. The muhtaj ilayhi. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense now? Now, inshallah ta'ala, that we've understood that, the Shaykh goes on to say, أَوْ وُجِدَ فِيهِ عِلَّةٌ, or a عِلَّة is found in it. That عِلَّة تَقُومُ مَقَامَ الْعِلَّتَيْنِ. That عِلَّة by itself can stand what? It can stand in the place of two. It can actually take the place of the عِلَّة Al-lafdiyah and the illa ma'anawiyah. This one by itself, it can take both of them. Are we all together? Then the illal that go back to the ism are all those three. That's why he says, وَالْعِلَى لِتِي تُوجَدُ فِي الْإِسْمِ وَتَدُلُّ عَلَى الْفَرْعِيَةِ. So here what we're looking at is what? Are we all together? We're looking at the far'iyah. The illa here that we're pondering on is we're finding an ism which is a far'ah. Are we all together? Does that make sense? We're finding an ism which is a sub-branch. That's not an asal. Does that make sense? The first one of the ilal is the one I wrote on the board. Al-mamnu' min al-sarf, right? The first illa is what? Illa. So here it is. Two illa. There's words that have two illa in it. The first one is illa. Alamiya and what? Wasfiya, right? Are you with me? Alamiya is what? It comes from the word alam. Alam. Sah? And what does alam mean? Alam means, it comes, you know the word alama, sign. When you make a sign for something, that's alama. Alam is basically whatever makes the person be known for. A name, whatever. It means that's what an alam is called. Are we all together? Generally, people use the word alam as a name, right? Are we all together? Because the word ism generally is more broader than an alam. Alam is actually a name. Like an ism is actually a noun. Okay, are we all together? Pay attention. Alam is a name. Are we all together? The alam is what? It's a fara of the at-tankir. The asal is what? That no one is known. The asal is nakira. The tankir is the asal. So the alam is a fara. Of what? It's a fara of the tankir. It's a fara of the nakira. Does that make sense? The sifa, which is here, is a fara of the mawsuf. It's a fara of the mawsuf. And then we have the fara here. So we're finding Are we all together? We're finding an ism that has these characteristics with what? The fi'l. Are we all together? So this is what we're going to tackle, inshaAllah ta'ala. So now we understood alamiya, what it means, sah? We understand what alamiya means, right? Are we all together? And we understand what wasfiya means, right? Which is that it's taken from the sifa. Is a fara of the what? Is the mawsuf. Pay attention here now. Let me finish my point first. The alamiya goes back to which one of the two? When we talk about lafdiya and ma'anawiya, which one is it going to go to? How is it al-meaning? Both of them go back to the ma'an. How? How? Okay, look, for example, the word rajul. Sah?
No.
What's it originally taken? The word, sorry, ar-rajulu is originally taken from what? What's the ziyadah here? Where is it originally taken from? It's taken originally from? Hey, where's the mushtaq taken from? The mushtaq minu. Does that make sense? So it goes back to the lafd. This one, alamiya, is lafdiya. It's just a wording. You have no meaning connection on it. This one has a meaning though. It needs it. It requires, sifa requires a mawsuf. It's hungry for it. Does it make sense? You can't have a character description without the person who you're describing. A description cannot just stand without the person or the thing that you're describing. Does that make sense? وَهَذَا تَرْجِعُ إِلَى الْمَعْنَى. This goes back to the meaning. صح? This is the ihtiyaj, and this is the what? The fact that it's taken from it.
Huh?
Anything that's ma'arifah is taken from a nakira. No one is known. Asal, nothing is known. Asal. The asal is that things are not known. Am I making sense? Yeah? No? Even then, Muhammad is not known. It's not specifically your name. It's nakira, asal. Huh? The asal is that no one's known. We can go into more details regarding that. Now we're going to go into the alamiya, how many forms they come into, and the wasfiya, how many forms they come into. Are you with me? Are we all together in that regard? So let's go to the alamiya, which is six that the Shaykh rahimahullah mentions. How many does he mention? He mentions six. The first of the six is what? Yeah? So the first one is al-alamiyya. The first one is a name. Ma'at-ta'neef is what? With a, it's a feminine, it's a female. But it's what? بغير ألف without an ألف صح. But pay attention, sisters and brothers. I want you to pay attention. The Sheikh said, the first example is a تأنيث, a female word that doesn't have an ألف. It's a female. This is a female, but it doesn't have ألف. صح. The female words in the Arabic language are three types. The words that are feminine, that we say is feminine, how many types are they? The first one is ta'neethun, it's a mu'annath. And it's what? It's with ta' marbuta. Fatima. Sah, and etc. Are we all together? Am I making sense? The second type of ta'neeth is what? Yeah? The second type is alif. The word is mu'annath, but it's mu'annath because it's alif maqsura or mamduda, it doesn't matter. Sah? The word is, it's a mu'annath because of alif at the ending. Humaira. It's a mu'annath word. Where is it? Because of the alif. صح قصوى مؤنث هذه نو بيكوز الف صح ان الثيرد وان از تانيث في المعنى the word is مؤنث but in the meaning not in the in the not in the are we all together it is تانيث في المعنى it is مؤنث in terms of what in terms of like زينب زينب there's no sign of the fact that she's what but it's in the meaning we know زينب is a female صح Huh? Pay attention here. So the first one is التأنيث بغير ألف. What enters there when we say تأنيث بغير ألف? Anything that's مؤنث in terms of its meaning and the other one that's مؤنث in terms of its تاء مربوطة. So is حمزة in there? Huh? Is حمزة in there? Then you're going to put it in ta'nith bighayri alif. Yeah? From what we see here, sahih. We put Hamza in there. Does Zainab go in there? Does Fatima go in there? Ta'nith bighayri alif. Fatima goes in there. Are we all together? All of them enter there. Very good. So any word that has a ta marbuta, any mu'annath, are we all together? Any mu'annath, بغير ألف, which is عالمية, that's the first illah. The second one is العالمية مع العجمة. The second one is عجمة. عجمة here means that this word is what? It's a foreign word. It's not an Arabic word. But it got turned into the Arabic language later, صح? Question. Are we all together? Does the Quran have non-Arabic words in there? Yeah? Good. Does the Quran have words that we can say they're not Arabic? They're not Arabic. Huh? Is there words in the Quran that are Arabic? That are non-Arabic words? Huh? The Quran is بلسان عربي مبين. Allah said that. بلسان عربي مبين. صح? But when we have names like عجمة, for example, Idris, and عقوب, and Ibrahim. And in grammar here we're saying it's عجمة. It's not an Arab name. Ibrahim is not an Arab name. Idris is not an Arab name. يعقوب is not an Arab name. They're عجمة. They're all foreign names. Do you not have these names in the Quran? Yaqub and Ibrahim and huh? You have these names in the Quran and Idris. You do, right? How do you reconcile between that? What you have to remember is that what you bring in, what you study in grammar, generally speaking, don't take it with you in the Quran. Some things that are said in grammar that are not taken into the Quran, صح? Like for example, وخلق الإنسان ضعيفا خلق الإنسان خلق is مبني للمجهول it's a على وزن is three form the letter word ضم أوله وكسر ما قبل آخره صح خلق so in Arabic language can we say grammatically when we look at the eye what do you say مبني للمجهول the one who did it is unknown huh can we say that grammatically yeah we used to say that but now when it comes to the Quran we have to have good etiquette We know who created. We know who created the human, right? And then some things when you do in grammar and you come to the Quran, the form in which you deal with it is different. In grammar, you can call it ujma if you want to. But when it comes to the Quran, the word Ibrahim, it became what? It became an Arabic word when the Quran took it. Huh? For example, we Somalis have words that are what? Italian, that we took from Italy. Italians. There were words that we took from the Abyssinians. There were words we took from the Arabs. Now this word to us is a what? It's a Somali word. What is it? It's considered as a Somali word. If somebody said to you, what are you talking? What language are you talking? What are you going to say to them? I'm speaking Somali. But you know there's two, three words in there that are what? That are outside the Somalian language. You took it out, it was borrowed. it becomes part of that language. And languages borrow from languages. All of these are alamiya, that's why. Imran.
Okay, so it's not, it doesn't break up into each one individually.
No, all of these are alamiya, that's the illah.
So the adam is obviously in that.
Ah, the word is Ahmed, it's adal. It's alam. The alam already is a what? Farah. The second type is ujma. More details this we left out, we leave it for another book. The ujma we did. The third one is at-tarkibul masji. The third one is what? The third one is at-tarkib al-masji. What does at-tarkib al-masji mean? Tarkib al-masji, what does it mean, aslan? The tarakib in Nahwa are three types, but they are more than that outside grammar. But they are generally three. The first one is called what? Tarkib isnadi. Tarkib idafi. And tarkib what? Masji. There are other tarakib that scholars mentioned, tarkib wasfi and etc. Huh? What does it mean, tarkib idafi? Is when it's two words, mudaf mudafun ilay, and they both made a meaning. Like Abdullahi, they're two words, but they're one now. Does that make sense? It's a compounded word. Abdullahi is tarkib idafi. Abd is a slave, Allah is a what? Is the creator of the heavens and the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this is called tarkib al-idafi. Somebody can't come up to you and say to you that this, if somebody comes up to you and says to you, Abdullahi, what are you going to say to them? If somebody comes up to you and says to you, Abdullahi, what are you going to say to them? Abdullah, what are you going to say to them? That you're going to look for more. Abdullah, what? What do you mean, Abdullah? You're going to look. But you can't say to you, but it's. Wasn't the kalam meant to be aqallu ma yata'allafu minhu kalimatayn? Aw akthar? It's two words. I'm giving you two words. Isn't it a complete sentence? Now, Abdullah is one now. But this tarqib is called tarqib idafi. This tarqib is called what? Abdullah is a. Mudafan al-mudaf ilayh. The slave of who? Allah. He's been attributed to Allah. There's another type of tarqib which is called tarqib al-isnadi. Tarqib al-isnadi is when they're speaking about kalam and they're saying that the word has to be more than one. The tarqib that they are talking about is this one. Are we all together? This is the tarqib that they're talking about, the compounded word. Meaning, ja'a Muhammadun. It's two words, but this is isnadi. It's what? It's a tarqib which is? Tarqib which is isnadi. Good. What's the third one? Tarqib, which is masji. Tarqib masji is really a person who takes two words. Like, for example, Ja'a Muhammadun is what? Is what? It was tarqib isnadi, right? Imran's now name is called Ja'a Muhammadun. He calls himself Ja'a Muhammad, مثلاً. And that becomes his name. Are you there? You can't now then say Ja'a Muhammadun when it used to be, it's a sentence, it's a complete sentence. We're like, Ja'a Muhammad is Imran. That's his name. And that happened to so many things, like the word Hadar al Maut. You know Hadar al Maut, right? Where's Hadar al Maut? It's a place in Yemen, right? But it's Hadar al Maut, death came. Are you with me? It's two words, Hadara and then Maut. It came together, this is called Tarkib Masji. Hadar al Maut is a place. You can't say Hadara and Maut used to be two complete sentences and they used to stand independently. You can't. Okay? This is called what? Tarkib masji. There are many words like that. Ta'abbata sharra, مثلاً. Ta'abbata sharra. Ta'abbata sharra was a man's name. But what did it mean, ta'abbata sharra? It means that he put evil into his armpits. That's a word. Ta'abbata sharra. That person put evil in their armpits. Okay? They took their weapon and they put it in their armpits. But then it became a man's name. Are we all together? Ma'di karab. It's two different words. Ba'labak, two different words. And these are called tarkib masji. Tarkib masji. What does masji mean actually? When two things become one. Mezj in Arabic language means when two things mix together and they become one. Ha? Huh? Idafi can never stand by itself. It's an incomplete sentence. Like, the masjid comes from what? The isnadi. Ah. It's referring to one thing now. Does that make sense? Abdullah can't be a what? Slave of Allah. Hey, still incomplete sentence. Are we all together? Like, in the masjid can be, it's a complete sentence, yeah. The masjid is a complete sentence, but it became one word of one person, right? Number four is any alam that finishes with what? Alif and what? What does it finish with? Alif and noon. Such as Uthman, Ridwan, Affan, and etc. زيادة ألف والنون is like عثمان رضوان. These are what? زيادة ألف والنون. Number five is وزن الفعل. What does وزن الفعل mean? It's like أحمد. It's like what? It's like أحمد and يزيد. It's like أحمد and what? And يزيد. أحمد and يزيد. What does it mean? وزن الفعل. Because we know زيادة ألف النون what he meant. We know تركيب المسجد what he meant. We know what عجمة meant. We know تأنيث بغير ألف what that meant. But what does it mean وزن الفعل? It's basically any noun that comes in the form of a what? A فعل. أحمد comes in the form of a what? Say I praised Allah. How do you say it? أحمد الله. I praise Allah, right? أحمد الله. Hey, what's his name, this man? Same. Does it not look the same? What about Yazidullahu alladhina tadaw? Yazidullah. Allah increases. Yazid is a man's name. Yashkur is also the same. Sah? There are many people's names who are what? It's a form of, it's the wazn, it's the construction of a verb. Good. Number six is adl. What does adl mean? Adl means أن يكون الاسم, that the noun is what? معدولا به عن وزن آخر, that it's taken from a letter, another word that it was from. It went through a straight stages, that the word went through stages, or a stage of course. This adl is really what? تقديري لا حقيقي. It's مقدر. You can't see. It's implicit. It's never explicit. You can't see it. Is that the words? How do you know it's تقديري? The grammarians made this. They said that the grammarians saw that there were words that came in the wazn of what? فعل. Any word that came in the word of فعل. عمر. زفر. أو هلوم مجرع. Anything like that. Words that came in the form of fu'al, they saw is غير منصرفة. It doesn't, there's no صرف. Huh? And there's no other thing except this alamiyah. And that's not enough for it to be ممنوع من الصرف. It has to fall under one of these five that were previously mentioned. So they said, it's مقدر that it came from, it got rooted from another word. So the qa'ida can be mustaqim. So Umar was taken from what? Amir. Umar is from Amir. Zufar and Zufar. So Umar and Zufar and Qutham, مثلاً, and Zuhal and Bula. All of these words, they are all ma'adul. For example, Umar is taken from Amir. Zufar is taken from Zafir. قاثم زاحل بالع. Take it from those words. Good. Those are the six that are what? ستة علل. Six defects which are لفظية. They all go back to the wordings. Huh? No, that's not the reasoning. Okay, yes. But that asal illa that brought it into this discussion is the fact it's alamiya. Are we all together? Oh, you mean Umar?
Yeah.
That's taken from Amir. How we don't, it's not something really. How do the grammarians know? Ask them, where do you get this from? It's muqaddar, they made this. ليستقيم القضية. So the issue, because they saw Umar is not going to take, it's not taking it. So then they said that this is the reason, only reason we can find for it. Because no other thing they could do with it, except that they said it's muqaddar. This is the qawl of the nuhat, the grammarians. Every point we can have more detailed discussions about it, inshaAllah ta'ala. Okay. Those are the six, inshaAllah ta'ala. We'll stop there, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. I'll take questions and answers from you all. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.